Welcome to Feed Dump, where we're trying to overcome our awkwardness, because we are all social taboos. I am leaving the seat up. Joining me this week is drunk before noon.
Constantly.
And vomiting on a nun?
What?
It's not really a social taboo.
You know what? I bet if you went out and vomited on a nun right now, people would look at you funny.
Well, that's what you get if you're drunk before noon, I guess.
Blech.
What's even less personal than giving someone the gift of a Starbucks gift card? Doing so automatically over Twitter.
I love you enough to get you a gift, but I don't love you enough to actually walk to Starbucks.
I love you enough to give you a gift, but not enough to look at your ugly fucking face.
It's only because of Twitter that I even knew it was your birthday, and now it's taking care of the present as well.
I completely forgot to get you a gift, so I'm going to get you something that does not interfere with my daily schedule.
I'm socially obligated to get you a gift, but not socially obligated to bother finding out what you actually like.
This bold future of information super coffee is not without its hoops. You have to connect your Starbucks account, which you need to have, with your Twitter account, and then @reply the tweet a coffee account with the Twitter username of who you're getting it for, who also has to have their Starbucks and Twitter account linked, and then they get a $5 gift card that they can redeem on their phone.
I'm sure this fills some sort of marketing niche, but the important thing is somebody needs to come up with this for beer, and then everybody needs to send me beer.
I would also like beer.
I will also take wine and certain spirits.
And chocolate. And candy corn. And puppies.
Oh my god, Twitter kitten gifts? Kittens!
We are nearing that technology. Last week, the Uber car service joined forces with I Can Has Cheeseburger and the Humane Society, and when you ordered an Uber car, you could check the kittens option, and they would bring you kittens to, like, snuggle and hang out with, and you paid for this, and the money went to the Humane Society, and then you had the option to adopt a cat or two if you wanted, but you could basically use an app on your phone to have someone bring you kittens.
This would probably actually be a really good tool for PMSing women, you know, just that extra little something to make them feel better. Do you want me to get you a drink?
No.
Do you want some chocolate?
No.
Do you want me to order you some kittens?
Yes!
The RCMP in Iqaluit responded to a strange report that there was a pair of decomposing human hands in the middle of downtown. Turns out that was not the case. They were not human hands. They were just decomposing polar bear paws. So it's fine.
It's not like they're fabulously endangered or anything.
Polar bear paws is nothing. I've got like 5 of them in my backyard.
So they killed a polar bear and then they littered. That makes them poachers and assholes. And now that I say that out loud, I realize that's not 2 separate categories of people.
What's going on here is similar to when you find a couch on the side of the road. See, they had too many polar bear paws cluttering up their yard, so they just dumped them in the middle of the town so they wouldn't have to pay the fees to dump them at the dump.
It's especially galling because everything is so well labeled. You have the blue bin for paper, the green bin for compost, and the white bin for polar bear paws.
Seriously, the city couldn't make it any easier for you. You have to do your part too.
It was Halloween last week. Do you know where your children were? Well, thanks to the app Track or Treat, you too could track the location of your children as they went off on their trick-or-treating escapades. Or you could go with them, like humans do. Or if, you know, they're too old that maybe it's not so cool to have their parents around, you could just trust your children.
Trust my children? Are you nuts? I raise them. I know what they're capable of.
Trust my children. Oh, I've been coddling them for 12 years and I don't plan to stop anytime soon.
Go trick-or-treating with my children? Are you crazy? That's why I have an iPad.
I love you enough to buy you a costume, but not enough to walk around the block with you.
Oh, look, hun. The kids are down by the river. Oh, they're in the river. They're going downriver. I'm sure it's just some sort of GPS error.
I'll bet you that this app could actually team up with that website that shows you where all the sex offenders are, so then you not only don't have to go trick-or-treating with your child, but you can send them 6 blocks away to the one with the least red dots.
That's gonna be tough, because if the kids find out about the sex offender website, guaranteed those houses give out the best candy.
No!
We are talking full bars.
I don't know what kind of full bars they're handing out, but don't go near the red dot, kids.
Well, now I want candy. I wonder if any of those sites have leftovers. Till next time, remember, there may be better sources for news, but they don't have this hat. Cause it's my hat. It's just my hat. It's nothing. It's it's mine. I wear it. Fits me. So that's a plus.
Do you want me to order you some kittens?
Yes!
All right, I'll order you some kittens.
Yay!